I really regret the things I did when I got to high school. It was meant to be my fresh start. It was the beginning of my future. But I pretty much stuffed it up, and now that I'm in grade 12, it's like biting me.
I very much regret the things I've done in the past, and I am very ashamed of the person I used to be, of my former self.
Whether it's I'm blaming her for how depressed and how suicidal I feel quite a lot, or whether it's her blaming her current marriage problems on me.
Right, we both enjoyed a good fight, and we sold all the holes we had to prove to make the other one leave. And I loved the way you looked at me, and I miss the way you made me feel. Just for you.
My name is Wes Rose. I am the current record holder for most suspensions in one term at Barabi Island State High School. It makes me feel horrible that I hold those records, actually. My behavior back in primary school was pretty much the exact same as every other kid, except for the fact that I climbed trees. I never got suspended. I never, never swore, pretty much. I was a good kid.
My name is Luke Williams. I am the current school captain at Barabi Island State High School. My behaviour back in primary school fluctuated greatly. From when I was in grade 5 and I thought being defiant was the right way to fit in, where I got in trouble almost every week and made life for my grade 5 teacher quite difficult, to grade 6, where I was selfish and thought that being the funny man making jokes out of other people was the way to fit in. And whilst I did get a laugh of the class, it did not make the other person feel too good.
I'm Alicia Campbell. I'm currently in year 12 at Barabi Island State High School. I have anxiety disorder and depression. Back in primary school, I guess you could say I had quite a large group of friends. I wasn't particularly friends with just one friends group, but quite a lot of them. But a lot of the people I sort of hung out with were, in the sense, kind of, I guess, would be the wrong crowd now that I think about it now.
My behavior when I entered high school was completely different to primary school, almost from day one. I was swearing and yelling and throwing punches, and I was so angry at everyone, and it didn't stop there.
Wes used to be a bit of a rat back in grade 8 and 9. He was a bit of a smart ass back in the day. Not do his work, not do as he's told. I'd always try to help him out as much as I could, but it always landed me in a bit of trouble.
When I entered high school, my behaviour stayed the same. I was still seeking attention from everyone, and since we entered high school, there was all the other kids from Barabi, so there were more people who, from Barabi State School, so there were more people who didn't know me. Most people found there's a chance to reinvent themselves. Me, I saw that as a chance to make more people like me.
He's a good guy. In year 8 he was a bit strange, a bit out there.
When I was doing that transition from primary school to high school, I guess you could say it was pretty easy, kind of a dream really. I had all of my friends from primary school follow me to the high school. It was because they were quite close together. It was only like one bus ride away and most of the kids lived within the district, so no one really went to another high school. So all of that bad behaviour and bad groups and just bad energy kind of followed me to my first year of high school.
Alicia, Ellie. I've had the privilege of teaching Ellie for her whole high school career. Ellie was a very shy student to start with. It took quite a lot for her to come out of her shell.
Wes Rose was in my year 11 Maths A class last year in 2014. Not only did I hear stories about Wes back in grade 8, but I witnessed some of his actions back then.
My marks were awful because I didn't think about, you know, I didn't think about marks. I just thought about, you know, trying to be cool and trying to get in with, like, you know, everyone else there and trying to fit in. And I focused more on fitting in and trying to be what my version of normal was, I guess, and what everyone else's version of normal was.
When it came to grade 9, I entered into the subject drama completely by default. I had failed to hand in my subject selection form on time and was placed in drama. But it was not long before I discovered that it was the right place for me to be. I started seeing things differently, I started seeing people differently. I started seeking attention for the right reasons. I started becoming a person worthy of people paying attention to.
Like, a lot of things have helped me to minimize the effect that the depression has been having on me. Like drama, love drama. Shakefest has had such a massive influence on me. I really only joined it to start with. I only joined Shakefest to get out of like school for a couple of days because I thought that would be cool, and I kind of liked film and television, you know. So I kind of combining that, I was just like, wow, I get to act, I get days off school, and get to do what I like to do, I guess. And I never would have thought the experience that I got out of that would be so like helpful to me and help shape who I am and make me into a better person.
Ellie also took part in Shakefest with a group of very talented young ladies, created a wonderful short film. The short film won for their region, and unfortunately they didn't win for the whole state, but they did win for their region, and it was a beautiful short film, incredibly intelligent. And Ellie as a performer was a complete standout. And to consider Ellie from grade 8 and 9 to now is just unbelievable. She's just come strength to strength, and it's wonderful to see that the arts can do that. Luke's performance in Shakefest, he was in a duologue with Josh Wellings. The two of them absolutely blew the judges away. They were incredible. They won for their division, and of course they were part of the winning group scene.
I love acting. Acting is, it's one of the best things that I've discovered. And I used to think it was, you know, really not my thing back in the day. But I just enjoy it so much. It brings me happiness.
Another really awesome moment for me was seeing Wes perform a monologue for Shakefest, and also so he had to get up on his own and present like an entire monologue from the play Macbeth, which he completely nailed. The judges were just blown away. So was I, felt like crying. But not only that, he was part of the group scene, and the group scene actually won the entire Shakefest competition. And I think for me, I was excited for the entire group, but to go from seeing Wes from that kid in grade 9 who didn't care about anything, who was interested in flipping desks and telling teachers where to go, to seeing him up on a performance, in a professional environment, presenting in front of hundreds of people, not only well, but the best out of 6,000 students, and actually winning. For me, that was personally a really powerful and wonderful moment in my own teaching career, to see someone come so far.
I've known Alicia Campbell since year 9. Alicia has undergone a change for the better since I first met her.
He's really weird. He like doesn't care what anyone thinks of him, but like in a really good way. he helps people and he's friends with everyone.
What do I think of Wes? I love Wes. Wes is one of my best friends. I've known Wes since primary school and he used to be horrible. He used to bully me and we used to fight all the time. And he was a horrible person. He used to make fun of me, but he's changed so much now. He's such a nice person now and he's got his head in the right place now. He's changed a lot.
I met Wes, he was in grade 9, he was on internal suspension. He was sitting outside Laser staff room and he was very angry human being.
I was swearing and yelling and throwing punches and I was so angry at everyone and yeah, it didn't stop there.
Why were you so angry?
It was touch night. Josh was meant to be there because we played in the same team with my dad and my mom, but he wasn't. And we'd understand that he'd been sick for the past 2 weeks and that he'd gone in for a knee reconstruction because he hurt it playing footy. But Vicky, mom's best friend, came up to me with a phone and said that Jing, Josh's mom, had sent her a message. Now, when I read it, it said, "Tell Kelly and Wes that Josh has cancer." When we walked in that first time, it was a shock. It was a very big shock. He had wires coming out of his arms and he was very skinny and he'd lost all his hair and he had no eyebrows. And we all just sat around him. We didn't talk for about half an hour, we just sat around him. And then, about half an hour in, he said, "Are you guys gonna talk to me?" And so we just kicked it off, we just started talking. Just like old times, we treated him exactly like he was normal. I played chess with him, and he beat me, twice. And it was just like it was old times. And he acted completely the same. And it was from there that Josh Adams and Jaden realized that Josh was exactly the same. Just because he had cancer doesn't mean that he was any different to how he was. But from there on it just got worse. Got it all up his leg and it began to eat away at his knee. It entered his lungs again and we didn't know if it entered his brain. But he had a lot of support from everyone, not just me, Jaden and Josh. He had it from the entire Braby High, most of Braby Island, Banksia, Braby State, Columbans. Everyone gave him support and looked out for him. He was never alone, and he loved it. He loved every bit of it. People were shaving their hair for him and big Be Brave and Shave things, and the Josh Day, Blue for Josh, all for him, and he loved every single bit of it, and we'd always wanted to thank everyone for it. Watching him try to be happy all the time, even though he knew that his end was near. And then everything just seemed to run smoothly for a little bit after that. We just kept waiting for the day and waiting for the call. But I went to see him, and he cracked his smile, and there was still no talking. But about 5 minutes into the silence, he started to cry. He stared at the roof and he cried. And naturally, Josh Adams started crying, and then I started crying, and followed by Jake. We all just started crying because we all knew what was going to happen. You know, in a week or two or three, Josh would be gone. Once again, I was suspended. And I'd gone to tell him, because that's what I always did when I got suspended, I told Josh. But this time he didn't ask me what I did, and he didn't ask me how it happened. He just got really mad. He got really angry at me. And he kept telling me, and I was an idiot over and over again, that I was stupid. And yeah, I was stupid. It was a dumb thing, but he then told me something that I will never forget. He said, Wes, I would do anything to stand up right now and walk to that school and attend there for just a day. And that hit me pretty hard. But it drilled something into my brain. It made me realize that what I was doing was stupid. I was just wasting my life, and how someone as good as Josh could have theirs taken away and mine, you know, just, and I'm still here. And it straightened me out. From then on, I decided that I would change. I would not be the same kid that I was. And the next time I saw Josh, he would see me differently to what he did. I remember the night that he passed away. I'd been with him every night, but that night I decided to go to a party. About 2 hours into it, my guy came up to me and told me that my dad was at the front. And I was like, oh, that's weird. I didn't tell him to pick me up until a few hours from now. And so I walked out the front, and a couple other people were there to pick up their kids. And I spotted my dad, and he was standing still, didn't move. And then as the light reflected into his face, I noticed there were tears, and I knew that there was no laughing, there was no talking. I walked straight into where Josh was being laid, and he was just there. His eyes were open. He wasn't moving. But I'd seen him the day before. And he just seemed like normal Josh. But he wasn't moving, he wasn't talking, but it just seemed like he could come back to life. It came to me that throughout our friendship, all Josh wanted me to do was be a good kid. And it gave me a little bit of comfort that in the last week, Josh was able to look at me and know that I was a good kid. And it hurt so much that I wasn't there to see him go, but yeah, it's probably a bad thing that it took the death of my best friend to turn me into a good kid. But Josh has been, and till the day I die, he will be my inspiration to be a better person.
And that's really all you want in life, I guess. That's what I think, to just be the best person that you can be and be your most happiest and most content self. That's my life goal, is to just be content, not to just not to worry about who I'm with or jobs or education or anything like that. I mean, you know, that is important, and don't get me wrong, that really is important to help shape who you are. But you know, you could have all that, but you can also be sad as well at the same time, and that's not something that I want to be. I just want to be happy. Yeah.
My life is pretty good now, actually. I'm happy with myself, with my future, with my girlfriend, and I'm heading in a way better direction than I was 2 years ago, which is a lot better than I thought it would be 2 years ago. 2 years ago my future was UV and now it's uni, so yeah, I'm happy.
I believe that my life has meaning. I believe all life has meaning. It only takes the influence of another, or a certain event, or the realization of oneself being bad, being not as the way they want to be, and developing their own personality as a means to discover the meaning to their own life. I will achieve great things in my life, and I will not face oblivion. A great human being will be remembered long after they are gone. And that is what I hope in my life.
I didn't want to hurt you, hope you know.